Hi everyone, and thanks for joining. This is Josh, and today I'm going to cover Fliki. So Fliki is a really cool new technology. It's going to allow you to create videos for Facebook, for YouTube, YouTube Shorts, your clients, whoever, and whatever your need may be. You can create a video with Fliki, and it's super easy. It's still important to learn about how to do it, so I'm going to cover some of the features, and we're going to create a video in this tutorial, and I'm also going to show you the pricing and where you can get some good discount codes at the very end. So for all that and more, let's get started. So first thing you want to do is sign up. Once you've created an account, simply log into your account and you'll see this landing page here. Okay, this is all of my content, so of course you won't see that, but this is where your files will show under the files default tab. So to the right of that, you're going to find the account tab, and this is going to show you your credit usage. So all the credit that you've used to date, because each plan comes with a certain amount of credit. So mine has 180 minutes. Below that, you'll find your plan information. You can cancel it here, upgrade it here, etc. So I'm going to go back to the file tab. And to the right of this landing page, you're going to find your main tools over here. So you're going to find very simple tools here for video, image, and audio. And basically, these are tools that would just allow you to trim your content, to crop it, to resize it, rotate it, and so on. And to the right of that button, you've got this little sunshine here. That's going to allow you to go into dark mode or a light mode. Below that, you can search or create a new folder. Now, when you're ready to, you can create a file with this little pink button right here. Click on that and it's going to open up this menu. So this is step one. And you can create a video file, an audio file, or a design file, okay, depending on what you want to create. I'm going to create a file on beaches. So I'm going to type in beaches there. My language is English, but you can select many, many others. You can also select the dialect here, okay, Australian, etc. Aspect ratio, in this case, it's going to be portrait. I'm going to do a YouTube short, but you can also do a square one-to-one Instagram, for example, or a landscape, which is a full YouTube video size. But again, I'm going to stick with the YouTube short size for mobile size. That's portrait 9:16. And over here, I'm going to select start with idea. But if you have a script already, in that case, you want to select script empty file. Okay. But in my case, because I want to generate an idea from a prompt, I'm going to click idea. Now I'm going to click submit, and you can see on the next screen, it's going to give me the options to actually enter in a prompt. So I'm going to type in this prompt here, best beaches in the USA on the East Coast. So it's going to make a short for me on the best beaches in the USA. And now below that, I can select the time. I can make it be as short as 30 seconds or as long as 15. I'm going to keep this at a minute. And you can see here the different stock media that you can choose. It could be videos or it can be made up of images. I'll choose images in this case. You can also choose templates here as well. And you can choose sound effects and include headings. So I'll include headings in this case. And now I will click submit. And now it's actually going to generate basically a 1 minute short in this format using stock images that's going to pull. So it's going to pull from its database. Now, bear in mind, it's not going to be perfect by any means. So in the next few screens, I'm going to show you how to actually edit the video. And that's really important to know because all of these tools now for generating video content make a lot of mistakes. So you're going to see here very soon that I'll need to update a lot of these images and also the font. So right here, I've got 9 scenes that were generated. So there's text and images associated with each scene. So I've got 9 scenes. If I scroll to the very top here, you can see here at the very top, it's already selected my media audio file. So if I can click here, it's now going to open this box up, and now I can see all the different options I have. So if I don't like that sound, if I listen to it and I don't like it, I can select one of these. I can even listen to it in advance and click there, and it's going to play the sound. And then if I really like it, I can simply select it, and now it's going to replace it. So it's actually just replaced that sound with Summer Friends. So that's pretty cool. Now below that, you can see your first scene here. If I click there, if I want to change the text, I can simply click in there. I can change all of it. I can delete all of it, or I can simply add something to it or edit it. I can also change the voice. So I click on this voice here, Sarah. Now you can see I've got all these different voice options. So I've got my favorites up here already, but I've also got standard voices, which is included in my subscription. And below that, these are premium subscription ones. They do give you a few freebies here, but most of them are only in the higher level subscription. You can also apply to all scenes here too by clicking the little box here. So I'm going to cancel out of that. and go back here. And now I'm going to show you how to actually change the image. So let's say, for example, I want to change this to something different. I'm not happy with this picture, or I want to change it to video. All I need to do is click here, click that image. And now you can see I can choose between a video, an image, or even a GIF. I'm going to keep this to an image, and I'm going to choose a different beach scene. So this is a pretty cool one. I'll select that one. Now you're going to see as soon as I select that one, it's actually going to replace it. So it's already been replaced. So it looks almost like the Jersey Shore there. So that's pretty good. And if I wanted to, I can even add another scene between these two scenes. So this is scene one here, and this is scene two here. If I want, I can simply hover my mouse below here. Now I can see this little plus icon. And if I click that, that's going to add a new scene. I can duplicate the first one, or I can actually delete it if I'm not happy with it. So pretty easy to do. And if you see here, if I click into this text box here, it's now highlight this header up here, so Coastal Paradise. And I can actually change the location of this by simply clicking below. And now you can see it's going to change the location, or I can do it manually. So I'm going to click that little box there, and now you can see I can actually drag this around and put it wherever I like. And I can do this with each screen. So you can, there's a lot of controls that you have here on the right-hand side. I can change the text color, the background, and even add an animation if I want to. Okay, so I can make it fade in or zoom in or, you know, whatever I like. So a lot of different controls here on the right-hand side that you don't want to miss out on. Keep that in mind. Okay, and lastly, when you're ready to download, all you need to do is simply click the download button and choose the resolution. In this case, I'm going to stick with 1080p and then the format, MP4. So simply click start export, and now it will download it, and it will take a few minutes. So I won't bore you with that. I'll go back to the website, and I'll just show you when you go to the pricing here, these are your pricing options. You can begin for free. You get just 5 minutes per month, which isn't a whole lot, or you can buy the subscription. And if you go with the standard yearly amount, it's $21. For the yearly subscription, you get 25% off automatically. Same thing for the premium, 25% off. If you want to do it month to month, it goes up to $28 for the standard and $88 for the premium. Now, don't forget you can get really great discounts. So I've got a few up here just to show you. Here's one with WeThrift. 50% off Fliki coupon, and these do change regularly, so there's no point in me giving you all these codes because they change all the time. But if you go to WeThrift, you'll find some good ones. You can go here to this site here, Naj, I think it's how, that's how it's pronounced. After that, you have got DealSpotter, which is another good site, and you've also got this one, Happy Checkout. Don't forget to check out my affiliate link in the description below. Once you click on that link, you're going to go to Fliki, and there you can actually choose which plan you want and then simply enter in the promo code, and you're basically good to go. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, I appreciate a like, and it would be great to have you subscribe to my channel. I produce lots of really short tutorials to quickly get you up to speed. So next up, we've got the video that I actually produced for this tutorial with Fliki. So I hope you like it. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.
East Coast Beach Bliss, America's finest shorelines. Imagine your feet sinking into the soft sand as the waves gently lap at the shore. That's East Coast serenity. From the sun-kissed shores of Florida to the rugged cliffs of Maine, the East Coast offers a beach for every traveler. Let's dive into the pristine beauty of Siesta Key, Florida. Its powdery white sand and turquoise waters are simply unmatched. In New Jersey, Cape May stands out with its Victorian architecture and vibrant boardwalk, adding a touch of elegance to your beach day. Finally, the rocky coasts of Acadia National Park, Maine, offer breathtaking views that remind us of nature's grandeur and beauty. Each of these destinations tells a story of relaxation, adventure, and unforgettable memories waiting on the East Coast's best beaches.